Across Yorkshire's moors and dales, the world's most famous vet set the benchmark for animal care. And James Herriot's legacy lives on. His former trainee, Peter Wright, has been a Yorkshire vet.
All right, fella, still shaking your head at me.
For 40 years.
Many years ago, this is what my old boss taught me to use, and it's done the job for me very well over the years.
New life.
It fills me full of so much joy.
Now running a new Yorkshire practice, Peter's former partner, Julian Norton.
Hello.
Also upholds the Herriot ethos.
I'm feeling a lot better, thank you.
And in the foothills of the Pennines, at one of the country's busiest animal hospitals,
so cool,
a new generation of town and country vets are following in their footsteps.
Shona's just touched me through the cow, which feels very strange.
Eight, two, one.
The vet teams have one common goal.
It's called the art of veterinary science.
I love it.
To help animals of all shapes.
Quicker than I was expecting.
Sizes.
Hello, dear.
Types.
Yeah, I'm on, big boy.
Ow!
And temperaments.
Good boy, I said, not bad boy.
It's definitely not glamorous.
It smells like mouldy cheese or something like that.
But it's varied.
Oh, Jake, I don't know whether I can.
It's rarely easy.
How did it escape?
But they continue the Herriot tradition.
They're a bit wild, the cattle up here.
Treating all creatures great.
Well, well, well.
Chill, chill, chill.
It's one of these jobs where you need your porridge before you start.
And small.
I need some glasses, he's so small.
Gentle streams. Powerful rivers. Mighty reservoirs. And cascading waterfalls, tumbling onto rocks. All provide a mesmerizing, murmuring counterpoint to Yorkshire's glorious green and gold pastures. But on the farmland, captains are never too far away from choppy waters. Near Thirsk, Peter's on his way to see his old friend Ivor Shaw, who has a sinking feeling about a newborn.
Just had a phone call from Ivor. He's just noticed that one of his calves that was absolutely fine a few hours ago is now very lame, and he's very concerned about it, and he would like me to go out and have a look as quickly as possible.
We think that the bulls or one of the other cows has stood on it. Worst possible outcome is that Peter won't be able to do anything for it, and we'll have to put the calf down.
Now, Ivor.
Now then.
I understand you have a calf that's on three legs this morning when you've come into work.
Are you coming to have a look?
I'll have a look, yeah.
Yeah.
How old a calf is it?
3 weeks.
3 weeks, yeah. All right, yeah. Yeah. Right, let's have a look.
Come here, little riddler.
It's very swollen.
It is. Do you think she's been kicked or something?
Yeah. I think he's been stood on, Ivor.
Yeah.
It's quite a nasty reaction there. When you look at an animal that's not weight-bearing, for whatever reason, you often fear the worst. She's broken it.
Oh, bloody hell.
Without doing something with this, this calf's in serious trouble. We're going to have to put a cast on here to immobilise the fracture site. Ivor's going to separate this girl off with her mother.
Come on.
That'll give her a bit of peace and quiet so she can sit with her feet up for a time until this heals.
She needs to be with her mum because her mum's feeding her. So she's only about a month old. Come on, lass. Come on.
In Wetherby, dog lovers keep the vet team busy.
Hello, Kirsty. This is why you come for biscuits. Yeah.
As do cat people.
I'll give her a jab to take the swelling down.
But But some pet owners do things a little differently.
Here you go, boysies. What are you doing?
Emma has rats.
Here you go, Riz. Good boy. We needed a pet for the family. Dogs and cats were out. So I did my research. It's like, yep, rats it is.
Don't you leap at me when we didn't do out.
It is really like having a bunch of toddlers. Just that you can stick them in a cage at the end of the day. For the littlers, this is the first time they've been pea fishing. Arthur's doing really well over there. They shell the peas and spit the shells all over the floor. Look at you. Look at you, pea fishing. Little piggy wiggy, we all gone. They're great for kids. Clever boy, Mercutio. Well done. It's not like a hamster that's really small and bites because it's that way out. Never mind kissing me. No. Hey, you girls. When I come in, I have to pay attention to both groups at once, otherwise we have temper tantrums. Don't we? Yes. There's nothing worse than a rat having a temper tantrum. They either get really narky with each other and push each other off, or they sulk. Rats are really good at sulking. Some of them are absolute masters of it, and they'll blank you.
And they might be giving Emma the cold shoulder today, because she's taken the rat pack on a road trip to the vets, where Julian's ready to play Pied Piper.
Hello.
Hey,
you all right?
Yeah, not bad, thanks. How are you doing?
All right, it does say lots of rats.
It's actually 18.
18.
They all need a full checkup. I told you I'll bring in the full mischiefs.
Right, you'll need a hand, will you?
Yeah, please.
OK, what could possibly go wrong? Well, checking over rats is not that easy. They're obviously quite small, they're very fidgety. You can't really do the normal kind of examination you would on a bigger animal, but we can listen to the heart, listen to the chest, check the colour of the membranes, and, you know, look at the general condition, the coat and the skin. Heartbeats in little animals are always much faster than in bigger animals. She sounds clear in there.
Right.
So what's next?
Right, let's go for Dax. She's one of the younger ones. She'll need weighing, won't she?
Yes, she will, yeah.
It's great when the customer tells the vet what he needs to do.
Well, rats, we see the odd rat. Generally, it's not, like, common to see this many rats. I'm just a bit...
confused.
Come slightly overwhelmed. Got some big testicles there, hasn't he?
No, they're pretty small for a rat.
I mean, to me, they're big testicles. I'd call them big. Look at them, they're like... go out to right down to his feet.
This is King Arthur.
You're nice, aren't you? What a cute little fella.
With 17 rats given the all clear.
He's good.
This is the last one. So who's this?
This is Scardy.
As Julian examines Scardy, he's found a lump.
It's quite big for a little rat. It's sizable, but it's soft and it's quite mobile. It's not in a great place. It's a difficult area to operate on around the throat. Rats do get lumps and tumours under the skin. They get mammary tumours quite commonly, and they can be nasty.
Oh, baby girl.
Coming up...
Found a nice meaty bit. 3, 2, 1.
Matt performs eye surgery on a much-loved sheep.
She's much stronger than she looks, that's for sure. It's a good old green grass here in Yorkshire, isn't it? Builds them strong.
And as they try to secure the calf's future...
She's in there.
Two old friends of James Herriot reflect on the past.
We used to get sat on table and we used to talk about calves, and he used to be talking away about that. I used to think, God, I hope you aren't charging me.
Near Thirsk, Peter's at Ivor Shaw's farm hoping there's a future for a calf with a broken leg.
I'm going to immobilise this fracture site using some very old-fashioned plaster of Paris. There are more modern remedies now, but this has always put me in good stead. Right, there's our patient. Good lass.
Whereabouts there?
Yeah, perfect. Hey, you've done that before, haven't you?
I've done that a lot of times.
Right. plaster up to there and down to there. Just straighten him up a bit, champion. Just slightly crooked, but it's not bad. She's in pain. When I put pressure on the fracture site, she's showing signs of pain, as I would be if I had a fractured leg. So just immobilising the bone is going to be very beneficial to this little lass. I've got a good nurse, Nurse Ivor, and... good job, I've known him a long time.
In fact, Peter and Ivor's friendship goes all the way back to the days of James Herriot.
You know, I remember coming back to work for Alf White, and I remember Ivor coming in when he had a lot more hair.
He used to dope dog, and then he used to get sat on table, and we used to talk about calves, and he used to be talking away about that. I used to think, God, I hope you aren't charging me.
No, I wouldn't. Life was, you know...
It was different.
It was different, wasn't
yeah,
it?
Everybody had
more
time.
Yeah. The pace of life, certainly when I qualified, was a lot slower than what it is now.
Yeah.
And I think that's very sad. People haven't time for each other as much now. That's set nicely. Firm. Right, good. I'm happy with that. You can rest now, nurse.
No, if
you... Right. Just give her some painkiller now. And this will last for a few days. Lovely. Right.
There we go.
Yep. Go on, miss. It'll feel a bit strange to start with. It'll feel a bit straight. Look, I knew, I told you it would. Yeah, we're off. That's it. She's a nice little calf, that, isn't she? Bonnie. Right.
Next few weeks, she'll be in this pen with just with her mother until we take the plaster off. So hopefully she'll be safe in here.
I'm expecting a good outcome, but there are things that can go wrong. For instance, the pressure of the cast can be too tight. If the calf grows very quickly, it can impede the blood supply and cause all sorts of nasty problems. So we'll keep a close eye on this calf.
In Wetherby, rat fan Emma is back at the practice with serious worries about two of her little pals.
I know. It's all right. Julian's going to come out to you soon.
Scard is here for surgery to remove her large lump. And Emma's brought in one of her other rats as an emergency case.
This is Ron, one of my neutered males who lives with my girls. His breathing is really, really bad. So we've rushed him in today. He's
blue around his mouth, which major sign of respiratory distress.
When you get to know your animals, you know when they're not right. I know, we're worried.
Do you want to come through?
No problem at all.
Hello, Ron.
He's not happy. He's breathing bad. His nose is flaring.
His sides are going in and out, aren't they?
Yep, side sucking's not a good sign.
Let's have a listen. And with this, he's come on quite suddenly then?
Yeah.
Yeah, it sounds like he's got a chest infection. We'll give him some antibiotics. I think it's a really strong one that lasts for 2 weeks, and it's really good for rats.
Okay.
It's really good for respiratory infections.
So, all right, I've got you.
We can keep him on oxygen for, you know, a couple of hours, at least till the drugs start to kick in. He'll just get the benefit. It's like having an oxygen mask if you're a COVID patient, and that'll keep him comfortable for the time until the drugs start to kick in.
So, with Ron the rat recuperating, Julian's turning his attention to Scardy's lump.
It's got quite a lot bigger quite quickly, so it's getting in the way of the leg, and we think we'd better take it off sooner rather than later. Fingers crossed it'll be straightforward, but rats are not always easy to deal with. Well, she's worried, is Emma, she isn't convinced that it's going to actually make it through the anaesthetic. The anaesthetic's a bit more complicated because they are so small. We can't give them the normal combinations of anaesthetics that we use for some animals.
For Julian and Nurse Lucy.
Scoop her out, that's it, and then just straight on there. That's it there, look.
This is going to be tricky surgery.
It's in an awkward position.
it's in the sort of armpit, so it's not a very good place to operate. There's quite a lot of important things in there, nerves, and it extends sort of slightly towards the neck. I don't know how easy it's going to be to take off, actually, because it's quite big.
Across Yorkshire, Jake Ratcliffe dedicates his life to animals.
Come on, Rusty.
We rescue and rehabilitate animals that are in need, whether they're disabled or they've been injured, they're victims of neglect, or in some cases, they're saved directly from the slaughter. We've got sheep, alpacas, goats, pigs, cows, donkeys, cats, chickens. You name it, we've more or less got it, and with a bit of love and TLC, they're all living the life of luxury and they'll see how the rest of the day's here.
But one of Jake's favourites, Sunshine the sheep, needs special care.
Sunshine's completely blind and mostly deaf. I've bottle-fed her since she's been just 2 days old, so she's an animal that's very close to my heart. She arrived with a slightly enlarged eye, but it's getting bigger and bigger to the point where her eyelid won't now be able to close when she returns to the paddock in the summer. It also poses a risk that she could walk into a fence or a fence post.
Matt's on his way to Jake's farm from the animal hospital.
Our concern is that that eye, if it gets caught on anything, is going to rupture and burst. And if that happens, that will cause excruciating pain and be a really, real big mess for us. So what we're going to do today is we're going to remove that eye to stop anything like that from happening.
The last thing you want to do is put an animal that you love so dearly through an operation. So, yeah, I'm a little worried. She's not aware that we're actually trying to help her, you know, whereas another animal that had all the senses might be aware that we're trying to help her. She's just constantly in fight or flight mode, so the calmer we can keep her, the smoother it'll go.
The plan is we're going to give her some sedation because things are a little bit riskier with an anaesthetic, and because we can take an eye out with just local anaesthetic, if you just stand still for me with a bit of sedation, that will be ideal.
There we go.
You keep occupied there.
There you go.
There we go. Let's find a nice meaty bit. 3, 2, 1. In we go.
She's much stronger than she looks, that's for sure. It's the good old green grass here in Yorkshire, isn't it? Builds them strong.
With keeping Sunshine calm a priority.
Clipping all this fur off, so we've got skin to work with.
Jake's partner, Rosie, has come to help.
OK, son.
OK, darling.
Then I'm going to put some local anaesthetic around the skin, and then I'm going to put some local anaesthetic around the eye as well.
Right, then. Good girl. So this might flinch a little bit.
Well done.
Anaesthetic in there.
Good girl, Sunshine.
Big team effort today, really. It's just making sure that Sunshine stays in the right position because you're working around such a delicate area. Until you've got the eyeball out, you've got to be really careful about putting the needles in the wrong spot. Way yo. And you've also got to be careful of your patient bolting.
Coming up...
What beautiful, beautiful coats.
Peter finds puppy love.
Stunning little baby, aren't you?
But a lost soul arrives at the hospital.
Hey, darling, are you coming home?
This is this black poodle-type dog running around, obviously lost.
And Julian's patient gets ratty.
Ow!
That's my blood. I'm not getting any thanks from the rat, and I'm not getting any sympathy from my nurses.
At the rescue farm near Huddersfield,
good girl.
Matt's preparing to remove Sunshine the blind sheep's eye,
well done,
which has become dangerously enlarged.
OK, darling.
This is a particularly gruesome operation, but in this case, it's certainly for Sunshine's own good. You can see how prominent the eye is there, and you can just imagine if that was caught on a little bit of metal or a bit of wood, the amount of pain and the amount of damage that would cause.
During the surgery, it'll be crucial to keep Sunshine still.
Calm, darling.
Which is where Jake and Rosie come in.
What about if I go to the front?
Well, Jake, you need to be over because you're stronger than me. It's fine, I'll hold her like that. Yeah.
That's it, we can work with that. I'm afraid, Rosie, that you're going to get wet legs.
okay.
Do you want to swap?
No, it's okay.
Do you take your gloves off? You're going to get blood all over them.
I'd rather have blood on my gloves than my hands.
Shouldn't you put medical gloves on?
Well, I'm not doing anything.
Fine.
Nah, should I have medical gloves on? Yeah.
Nah, you'll be all right there. It's just holding it.
Bought them gloves for Christmas, but whatever. You know, ungrateful and all that.
She shouldn't feel this at all. The only thing that she'll be able to feel is a bit of tugging and pulling, but all being well, that should be limited as well.
Good guess.
Now I've got the eyeball all anaesthetised, the lid's been nicely stitched over it. Right then, let's get this sorted.
Good guess, chap.
What makes this trickier than a normal surgery is that the eyeball is particularly big and I don't know what structures I'm going to find at the back, so I've just got to take it nice and steady. There's no real fancy way to do this other than you've just got to almost tear the muscles apart at the back of the eye to get it all out. She's been an absolutely fantastic patient. We've got a good massage going on, we've got an expert holder. Not every sheep gets this kind of treatment. Here we go. And out we come.
Well done, Sunshine.
Good girl. I'm going to pack it out with some cotton wool. That cotton wool will be making sure that any bleeding absorbs and it just helps that healing process.
Well done, Sunsh.
That's it. Right then, let's get you stitched up, missus.
She's been absolutely brilliant. I'm thrilled with how it's gone.
Right, I shall get that cleaned up for her and put a bit of spray on it.
So, yeah, everything went smooth and she can get sprayed up now and be back with her pals.
Silver eye patch for Sunshine, eh? You can't get more pirate than that.
Lovely.
Job done. Eyeball out successfully. Sealed up really nice. There's not been half as much blood as I expected. I think Sunshine will be up and running in no time.
It's great to see Sunshine up and about. The operation's gone really well. Quite fiddly.
Good girl.
But I'm pleased to say that we can all rest assured now she's not in any danger. She should heal up well and she'll be none the wiser.
There was always a risk that she could impale it, you know, like walking into a fence post or something. So it's a massive weight off our minds knowing that risk's been taken away and she's safe.
I think it's a nip over for some special lettuce and apples for tonight's supper. She might even get double portions if she's lucky.
Some jobs a vet can look forward to more than others. Over in Kirby Moorside, Peter's expecting lots of little paws.
I'm quite excited because I've got some puppies coming in as I've got to vaccinate. And I've been told that these puppies are quite cute, Dachshund puppies, and I've been told they're actually quite stunning. So I'm looking forward to seeing them. This sort of procedure is what I would refer to as a nice little job, and as long as they're healthy, it's totally stress-free. So, yes, it's just my cup of tea, this one.
Hello.
How are you?
Thank you, how are you?
I've been hearing about these babies.
Oh, I know. My mum doesn't stop talking about them.
Well, I can see why. Even already, I can see they look absolutely... Oh, beautiful. Beautiful coats. Have you had a litter before, Daxies?
No.
First one? Wow, brilliant. First impressions with these puppies, they haven't let me down. They're absolutely beautiful. The markings are all different on each puppy. And these babies, it's hard for them because they're coming out for the first time, really. But we'll make it as stress-free as possible, won't we? That's the best we can do, isn't it? We don't have any stress, do we? No, we don't. None of us. Right. Now, let's have a listen to you. There's no need to worry. Uncle Peter isn't going to do anything nasty. Just listening to the heart here, sometimes puppies and kittens can be born with heart abnormalities. So we're just making sure that we haven't got anything untoward going on, and this puppy's absolutely fine. Not a whimper. You were very brave, weren't you? Very brave.
You come off.
Stunning little baby, aren't you? Nice wide open ears. Boys have a little bit extra that we've got to check. And we've got the necessary number there, which is good. Took it like a man, didn't you? Oh, you're big, aren't you?
It's a big boy.
Big
chap. Biggest out of the lot.
There now, that wasn't too bad, was it? Hey, am I forgiven?
Oh, look at this. Look at this. Beautiful. It's like a map of the world, isn't it? Who's this chap?
It's called Randy.
Randy?
Randy.
Why is he called that?
Randy by name, Randy by nature.
He's a bit amorous,
isn't he? Oh, he's worst out of the pack.
Really?
Yeah. Quiet, that... He's quiet now, but...
Yes. Quite big testicles, those. Well formed, well developed. So you're the head of the game, aren't you, my old mate, hey? Well, Randy, I'll hand you back to your mother.
Thank you.
It does really warm the cockles of your heart seeing babies like this. Well, we're all official now.
Thank you.
There's the vaccination cards. And the three of them will need to have a second one in a month's time.
Yeah.
Right,
thanks
very
much.
Thanks
a lot.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye. Sometimes, as vets, the work we have to do isn't always nice. So when you have a job like this, you make the most of it and really enjoy it. And I'm going to go away onto my next job now with a spring in my step.
In Wetherby...
Right, are we good to go?
Julian and Lucy are about to remove a large lump from Emma's pet rat, Scardy.
Emma didn't think there was going to be a good chance of success. She isn't convinced that it's going to actually make it through the anaesthetic. She all right?
Yeah, I'm still breathing all right.
Now, this looks very much like a cancerous kind of thing. There's glandular tissue there. It's knobbly and very irregular. Come off better than I was expecting, actually. So it's just a case of closing the skin, really. You all right?
Yeah, we're all right so far, handling it quite well.
Right, done. We'll just put some little blobs of glue on just between the gaps, just in case she nibbles it out. So that's gone nicely now, everything to plan. We're not there yet, because the next stage is the final stages of recovery, so all this is for nothing if the next stage doesn't go to plan, so fingers crossed.
Oh, hello.
Is she awake? Oh, look at that.
Hello. What happened?
Well done. I think she wants some food now.
You hungry?
We've got the paste. That'll be a nice post-anaesthetic treat.
I know, careful.
But Scardy doesn't seem overly grateful.
Ow! She bit me. That wasn't a very nice thing to do. Went right in then. Look at that!
Yeah, please.
I'm bleeding. That's my blood.
Of all the thanks we get, little rat, for taking your lump off.
Just everywhere, buttering. Bloods are going everywhere.
Oh, you naughty little rat.
Naughty rat, yes, exactly. So, everybody's laughing at me, look. So I'm not getting any thanks from the rat and I'm not getting any sympathy from my nurses, which is not very nice. Right, come on, let's put this rat away. Excellent. So that was sort of a successful ending. Rat is cured and vet is injured. Emma will no doubt be delighted because she didn't think that was going to survive the surgery. Scardy's fine. That went well. The only thing that wasn't fine is my finger.
You bit
ya?
Yep. Well, that's what everybody else said. Everybody was laughing, but it was quite serious.
How bad?
Quite well. I've glued it with glue.
So with one rat on the road to recovery...
She's looking pretty good, nibbling on dried fish.
Julia needs to check on Emma's other rat, Ron.
Ron's been resting in this oxygen chamber. He's got an infection, a respiratory infection, and we've kept him on oxygen for the last few hours, and he looks much better, actually. So I think all these guys can go home now. Good result.
At Jake's rescue farm, the future's looking brighter for Sunshine after Matt removed the blind sheep's enlarged eye.
Sunshine, it's me. Hi, darling.
She was a little disorientated. Once the effects of the operation subsided, and yeah, she was soon back to buying out for more hay, wasn't you, darling? So this is her first day back out in the fields. Obviously, with Sunshine being completely blind, she needed just a little extra assistance getting down to the field. Good girl. So she's got her very own specialised, personalised harness. Come on, then. Good girl. It's fair, darling. Come on, darling. Times like these that you get all the rewards for the hard work and effort that you've put into helping these animals. Obviously, without us stepping in, she wouldn't be here today. So it's really rewarding when you can see her happy. She's absolutely no worse off not having that eye. Obviously, she was completely blinded before, and yeah, it was constantly a worry that I was going to get a phone call at work one day and Sunshine had injured herself. So. It's one less thing to stress about. Oh, we've just got to worry about the other 500 things now at Sanctuary you've got to worry about every day.
At the animal hospital in Huddersfield, recently, Davey's been arriving with company, his rescue dog, Yogi.
We've been taking Yogi in for some behaviour classes at the practice, and he's doing really well.
Go on, Yogi. Come on.
Perfect.
Yes, good boy.
Good boy.
Oh. But he's still got quite a few bits to learn.
He says, I'm having both, Dad.
Yeah.
Yogi.
Walk right past him.
And even if Yogi isn't quite ready for Crufts just yet...
Yogi, come on.
He's become best in show for David and his girlfriend, Meg.
Nearly finished. He's settled in brilliantly, hasn't he?
Yeah.
So, and we absolutely love him. And he's
Wouldn't
part of the family
it.
Now.
Yeah.
I've always loved animals. It's certainly the biggest reason that I became a vet. I think they can form such a special part of the family.
So David knows how worried any owner would be if their dog went missing. And this morning, Ian's just arrived at the hospital with a stray.
You just found it, have you?
Yeah. Well, it's obviously well looked after.
Right.
But it was just running around in the centre of Oldham, and it was very... upset, you know, it's very distressed.
Okay. Hey, darling, are you coming out?
Come on, then.
Well, we're going to the opticians. There's this black poodle-type dog running around, obviously lost. And so we've just picked her up, and we thought the best thing to do is bring her here to the vets, and then hopefully someone will come and pick her up and they'll at least know they're safe. I bet they're running around looking, wondering where on earth it is.
Let's take her through to her room. I'm so glad Betty's here with us. It would be awful if she was lost wandering around by herself. Come on. We'll spoil her a little bit while she's with us. It sounds like she's had a traumatic day so far. I just hope we can get hold of the owner.
Still to come.
Have you seen a rat buster collar?
The Lord of the Rats.
Looks like an Elizabethan rat. Sir Walter Ratley.
And although she's clearly able to evade some predators,
I don't want to sound disrespectful, but we're not as young as we used to be, are we?
Has the calf's broken leg healed?
This is the moment of truth. When this plaster comes off, we'll see how well we've done our job.
Some pets are dressed for fashion.
Come on, Spider-Dog.
And occasionally, vets need to accessorize them for healing purposes. But when it comes to Emma's rats, Julian's picking up some tips.
We haven't tried these before, but if we can always try them. Collars.
Excellent collars.
The collars, just to help prevent them from getting to the stitches. Rats love eating stitches.
Yeah, I've never seen anything quite like these before. The ones put one on a chicken that didn't work very well. It's like a rubber ring. Yeah. But I've never seen one for a rat. They look like flowers.
Over in Huddersfield...
Is it blue? Yeah, do you want to come through?
Rohin has his own fashion faux pas to deal with.
I'm stuck with the pink stethoscope today. I'm not sure that's my colour, but we'll go with it.
And as he embraces the pink and examines Blue's problem...
It's a bit of a sore patch there, isn't it?
It looks just kind of like a superficial kind of bacterial infection.
You said you have seen him kind of licking at it a lot.
Yeah.
If he's going to keep on licking it, that can stop it from getting better.
He's thinking the pug needs a new wardrobe.
We have them like a little medical T-shirt. Yeah. We'll get a T-shirt on it. Up. Is that right?
Yeah.
Come on, then, young man. Come in with me.
Have you seen a rat buster collar? We've got different colours and different designs. So they go, head goes through there. That's adjustable, look.
Can they keep them on?
I don't know, we'll find out in a minute.
But whatever they're modelling...
Let's see what fits. Ready?
Some animals will never belong.
Steady, steady.
Rising.
There we go.
On a catwalk.
Oh, look at that.
Wow.
Looks like an Elizabethan rat. So well to Ratley.
It's one stylish dog. Oh, it's so cute.
High of fashion.
It's absolutely adorable. Medical purpose aside.
Come on. It looks quite smart.
I just wonder what all these other rat friends are going to make when it goes home with this on its head.
Excellent.
Not concerned with fashion, just desperate to get home, is the stray dog that Davy's looking after, who was brought in by Good Samaritan Ian.
You're all right now, kiddo.
Yeah, I know, I know. I'm sorry. I thought I'd got a treat for you, but I haven't.
I've got some treats.
Hey, Mrs. Shall
we get you a treat?
OK.
All right,
thanks a lot.
Leave her with us, all right. Thanks for bringing her in.
Good girl.
We get dogs that have run off probably every day, and we get all sorts of species with stray dogs. We had a stray tortoise a couple of weeks ago. Stray cats, all sorts. Shall we get you dried off then? Come on, missus. Come on, good girl. Evie, just got this stray. Thought I'd just give her a bit of a towel off.
You've been on walkabouts.
Come here, hey?
Good girl. Have you lost a dog, a black dog? She was wandering around, obviously lost.
Your mum would be really worried about you. It'd be so nice to get that phone call, though, when you're panicking and, you know, you've lost your dog and you're rushing around and someone says she's safe and sound. It's a nice feeling.
She's OK. She's very friendly and she's not hurt.
Come on, then.
All right, thanks a lot. Bye. She's going to come down and get her. She was in the garden and she's obviously escaped.
Betty's owner's on her way down now. It's a good job she was wearing a collar with a name and number on. Fortunately, thanks to Ian's quick thinking, I think she's going to be absolutely fine.
My dog in, I think. Betty.
Oh, yes, that's fine.
Long legs, skinny thing, she's had a terrible hair.
A black dog.
Yeah.
I'll let them know that
you're here. Thanks very much, thank you. I didn't know she'd gone. I'd literally just got out of the shower. She has got out once before, which is why we know where the escape route is, you see, which is why we put the bit of stone there. But that's been moved, and I didn't realise when I put her out in the garden. We were lucky, though, because it is a busy road up there, so I think we must have just got her just as she'd got outside. Betty Boodle! What are you doing? You're not together. Thank you.
Welcome. I'm really glad to see Betty back with her owner. I know that if I lost Yogi, I'd be beside myself with worry. It's all part of being a vet, and it's one of the best bits of the job, seeing owner and pet reunited together.
All right, thank you. Come on, you. Escape.
Even the most experienced farmers have new experiences, which is what happened recently, when Peter's old friend, Ivor Shaw, discovered that one of his calves had a broken leg.
Been farming 40 years, and this is the first time that we've had to put a plaster cast on one. The worst thing is, it wouldn't have healed, and we're back to square one. But Peter's coming today. We're going to take the plaster cast off, and hopefully it'll have been a success.
How are you?
Not so bad, how are you?
I wasn't grumble. Wasn't grumble at all. How's our patient doing? He's certainly grown since
he's grown, yeah.
The worrying thing is the bone's growing underneath still, and if you leave these plaster casts too long, it can restrict the blood supply.
Yeah, I thought if you don't come soon, it's going to get tight.
I know, and then we're in trouble.
Yeah. Off to you.
Thanks, Ivor.
You grab it, then.
I don't want to sound disrespectful, but we're not as young as we used to be, are we? Now, we're not quite as fast. Interestingly, she was standing there. She was taking more weight on a bad leg than she was on a good one, which is a good sign. Are we going to do them in this corner?
We can do.
Can do, yeah.
Can you get...
Brilliant. Fantastic. What technique. I'm very impressed by your handling skills, Mr. Shaw. This is the moment of truth when this plaster comes off. We'll see how well we've done our job. Be a funny sensation.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, I know. We're nearly done. We're nearly done. Now then, be nice. There we are, madam. That's where the fracture was. You can feel the callus there, which is part of the healing process. When we break an arm or a leg, you get this thickening around the fracture site, and gradually that'll remodel over a period of time. But that is really firm. I'm very pleased. As solid as a rock is that.
Good job.
Right, miss. Now then, that leg's gonna feel a bit funny, isn't it? It's funny now watching her, getting used to not having a plaster on because she's accustomed to it now. She's kicking her leg out behind, saying there's something not quite right there. That left leg of mine feels a bit light. Wants to be back with her mother, doesn't she? If you didn't know, you wouldn't know which leg, was it?
No,
would you,
really?
You just give nature a bit of helping hand.
Yeah.
And it does the rest, doesn't it?
Yeah.
No, it's really satisfying, a job like that. This calf now can lead a very normal life. She can skip about to her heart's content. So I'm very happy that I've been able to help out.
And it's not long before she's ready to really stretch her legs.
All the mates went a couple of weeks since, so she's ready to get out. It'll be a new experience because it's never been out before, so we'll see how she goes. Go on. It's a good time of year when they get out, a bit of fresh air, a bit of grass, and you can see that they really enjoy it. I think they were ready to be out. You always have the feeling, has it healed or is it going to fracture again? But it shows how well the leg's healed, and it's a real pleasure to see you.
And the Yorkshire Vet returns next Tuesday at 8. Now, when there's something sus going down, there's a new investigator in town, the Madame Blanc mystery, starring Sally Lindsay, is brand new Saturday night at 9. And tonight, we're back in the Dales for a tough few days for our Yorkshire farmers. The family say goodbye to a much-loved four-legged friend. Join the Owens in just a moment.